What's up, guys? Welcome back again to my channel, Engineer Tina Academy. It's your guy Christine here, and today, very first, we are going to look at how can we get formwork for the beam. If you want to construct a beam, you don't know the amount of timber that you need for that beam, we are going to start with all the elements, even the ones that support the beam. As you can look at the drawing, we have the beam here, we have the timber, we have the props, we have the struts, we have the braces. So we are going to calculate the formwork, the entire formwork of that beam. So let's get started. Now, this is what we are going to use. This is the plan that we have. This is what we are going to use. The details of the beam section are given here, starting from the side and soffit board. We have the cleats, we have the runner, we have the struts, we have the timber piece, we have the head tree, we have the braces, we have the props, the wedges, and the sol plate. And the sizes of the timber differ, so each member has a different timber size, so we are going to do the calculation separately. So the members are there, we've listed the members for you there, for the timber members that we need. We are going to start with the sideboarding. Sideboarding is this side here. You can see it's this side here. So it has a width of 450, and then we are assuming 15 meters length of the beam. So the size of the timber for sideboarding is 150 by 25 millimeters. So how many number do we need here? So it's 450 divided by the length of the, sorry, the thickness of that timber, which is 150. So if we divide by, we find that we need 3. So there are two sides, this side and the other side. So we multiply by 2, that gives us 6 pieces. So the length that you're going to require for the sideboarding, the entire timber length will be 6 times the length, which is 15 meters. That gives us 90 meters. So we go to the soffit. Soffit is down here. It is 300. The size of the timber is 150, so we divide by 2. You'll find that down here we need two timber pieces, which has a length of 15. We multiply by 2, that gives us 30 meters. So the side and the soffit board, because they share the same timber size, the length will be 90 plus 30, that is 120 meters. So if you want to cut your timber for the side and the soffit board, you're going to require 120 meter of 150 by 25 millimeter timber. Let's go to the cleat. Cleat is this element that supports the side boarding here. They are spaced at 75 millimeter center to center. So let's find the number. The entire length of the beam is 15,000 divided by 750, and then we add 1, that is 21. This side is 21, the other side is 21 times 2, that gives us 42 times the length of that member is 0.45, that is 450. That gives us 18.9 meters for the cleats. Let's go to the runners. The runners are these horizontal members. We have been told there are two, so to this side and to the other side, that makes 4. So it's 4 times 15, the length, that gives us 60 millimeters. The size of the timber is 50 by 75 millimeters. Let's go to the struts. These are the struts here. They are 45 degrees from the head tree. And then let's find the numbers. How many are there? They are spaced at 150 millimeters. So it is 1500 by 150 plus 1. That is 11. 11 this side, 11 the other side by 2. That is 22. So the length, if we extract that one, we are going to form a triangle. So we use the sign here to get X, the length of the strut. That gives us what? Gives us 0.64, so the length will be 0.64. There are 22 numbers, that gives us 14.08 meters. Let's go to the timber piece that is supporting these struts. The size is 0.575 by 0.575 by 0.50. They are 22, so it's 22 times 0.75, that gives us 16.5 meters. So we are proceeding to the tree head. The tree head here, we have our tree head here. This one here is 75 by 100 by 75 millimeters, tree head at 150 millimeters center to center. So we find how many are there. So it is the length, which is 15,000 divided by 150, so divided by 1500 plus 1, that gives us 11. So the length of the tree head, we've been told, is the length of that tree head is, the length is from this point up to this point, 1200 millimeters, that is 1.2 meters. So the number times the length, yeah, the number is 11 times the length 1.25, that gives us 13.2 meters of 100 by 75 timber piece. Let's go to the braces. The braces here, this one is our tree head. This one is our tree head, and then we have the braces. The tree head is 1200, so we divide by 2 to get 1600, and then now we can find the, we can find the, it is at 45 degrees. It has an angle 45 degrees. So we find the length of that brace X. X here is going to be cos 45 is equals to 600 over X, that is 0.85 meters. The braces, they have the same numbers there as the tree. Head tree, the head tree were 11. So for the braces, they are both sides, this side and this side. So it is going to be 11, but there are two on one prop. So 11 by 2, that is gives us 22. So the total timber length will be 22 times 0.85, that gives us 18.7 meters. We go to the props. The props are 11, and then we are assuming a height of 2000. So it's the timber length will be 11 times 2 meters, that gives us 22 meters. Yeah, and then we go to the wedges. The size of the wedge is 150 by 75 by 25 millimeters. The length of the wedge, the timber length, will be 0.5 times 2. There are two, because we have this one here and this one here, so you can see there are two. So we are going to have that one by 2. Yeah, by 2. So it is going to be 0.75 by 2, that is 16.5 meters. And then we go to the sole plate. And then we go to the sole plate. The sole plate is going to be 200 by 50. And then the length is 11. There are 11, sorry, there are 11. And then the length is 0.2. That gives us 2.2 meters. So that is how you calculate the, you calculate the timber sizes of the timber length of the beam formwork. So if you have same sizes, you just combine and get the total. If they are different, so you are going to cut your timbers according to those lengths. Thank you guys for your time. Until next time, bye bye.